We'll see and hear firsthand
this kind of sound.
Let's hear the rest of it.
We're back. All right, am I recording? I am. All right, good shit. Yo, welcome back to Shintendo Friday. I'm one of your hosts, Sobo Ryu. Over on another station right now, popping is Shoji Romero. Let me get up that. Let me get that channel up here. What was I thinking? What was I thinking, man? Let me get this up on the screen, man. Yo, where is this? I thought I saved it. What the fuck, man? Hang on, Shin. Oh no! Don't do that. Don't do that. Yes. I see. Give me a second, guys. I thought I had my shit together. I do not, but I'm back. You're watching Shintendo Friday. It's been a while since we had one of these sessions, but here we are, man. We just finished playing Smash Brothers on the Wii U, and we're moving on to Splatoon. So if you got Splatoon on the Wii U, feel free to join us, man. Hit us up, man. We're having fun. Show is also streaming on his channel. For those who don't know, that is over on YouTube.com. twitch.tv/ShojiRomero, hitbox.tv/ShojiRomero, and youtube.com/TheShojiRomero if you're streaming on YouTube. I will say, with show streaming right now, on Twitch, I know we just got informed, shoutouts to Eric, aka Crestborn. He let us know that Twitch is doing a program so that people who are not partners on Twitch can now become kind of partners on Twitch and make an income, I guess, on Twitch. Over people watching the streams, but it does require us to stream more often, so I'm gonna see if that works out for us. We'll see what happens, but that's our communities channel if you guys have never been there before. I'll put the link in the chat. You can keep an eye on what we're doing and get to either of the channels through there. It's like a portal to whenever we're streaming. You can do that there. And thank you very much for doing so. I appreciate it. Anyway, Splatoon is popping. Let me see if I can get a visual. Oh, yeah. There we go. Woo! Yo, it's popping, baby. Let me see if show's on Discord. He may be on his own in his channel. Let's see if I can find him. He's not there, man. Show, what's going on? Radio silence? He just wants that radio silence. I see you, show. I see you. All right, let's get back to the chat, then. Until show pops in. Let's do this.
Person, they can, like, hey, can you put that back? Like, they're not allowed to. There's no loss prevention.
All right, I'm back, guys. Let's do this.
Welcome back.
Hey. Oh, I got the wrong controller in my hand. I forgot I got to use the fucking Game Gear. Fuck.
That reminds
hey,
me.
Hey, come this on. It's a good controller.
God, it's like this fun. Thing.
Oh, it's 5 times better than the Game Gear, including the battery life.
Man, no, I beg to differ. JC says, what time is Mario Kart? It's going to be after 12:30. I'll probably take another break before we do Mario Kart, though, so be on the lookout for that. I'll try to wrap this up probably around 11:20 or so. Sorry, 12:20 or so. But here we go. All right, let's do this. We're going to jump in and join show.
Show is still like 1 minute 30 seconds to wait, so...
Yeah, yep. We're in a game right now.
All right. I'm in his game. I'm getting my ass kicked.
Holy shit, hold on a second.
What's up?
Mm-hmm. Alright, let's see what's up.
On that's a different note, that I was going to say a little bit earlier, but I know Morgan was watching it. But Xavier or anyone else, did you guys kind of check out the Power Rangers Marathon on Twitch? Or not really? Or
I know we caught a glimpse during my barbecue the other day. That was happened to be the opening weekend of Power Rangers in the theater, and that marathon was still going. All 840-something-odd episodes of that shit. It's like, what? Sweet the fuck? Jesus. God damn.
It went on for the better part of at least a week anyway. So
damn.
I think a lot of people dropped off after the first Zabat era, I think, sort of.
Yeah.
Because after Time Force and Wild Force, it kind of goes in wonky directions.
Yeah,
sometimes.
The quality of the series goes kind of dovetails.
What about the Disney years, man? I heard that was the best years.
Okay, so bro.
Let me fix my face.
Disney years are kind of mixed bag.
Oh my gosh.
Like, the best one out of that is Dino Thunder and SPD.
Right.
Yeah.
And RPM.
Which are awesome. RPM was also Disney, right?
Yep, that was the last Disney one.
Yep, that's also another excellent series.
So how many of these Power Rangers shows have the words ninja or pirate in the title?
How many the words have...
Samurai.
How many words is dinosaur themed?
How many were dinosaur themed?
I don't know, so many you wish went extinct.
There's only two. Dino Charge and Dino Thunder. You could say the first one, but then again, that was dinosaurs and prehistoric monsters. Or
yeah.
Yeah.
True. And the next one they're doing is another ninja one.
Oh, Ninja Steel? That's the current one.
Yeah,
well, speaking
that's
of,
the current one. So
speaking
like,
of... Oh, go ahead.
Nope, can you?
No, I was going to say, speaking of Power Rangers, who saw the live-action movie? Who went to the theaters to see it? Was it
I
good? Was it worth a... It was a sequel worthy? Was it worth a follow-up?
I heard it's actually pretty good.
It was okay. It's
sequel worthy? I could probably see, maybe, eventually. Oh, if man. Lionsgate wants to spend that cash. But knowing Lionsgate, you know how they are. So
yeah, I mean, I'm afraid it's going to end up like this. The other Power Rangers sequel that they came out in theaters years
Turbo.
Ago with, yeah, where it had such a low budget because the first movie didn't make shit, so they released pretty much the second movie on almost a TV level budget, and that shit looked
well,
shit showed.
It was
showed.
Also the start off the Turbo series as well. It was like a start off of the Turbo series anyway.
It was
so.
The pilot, yeah, essentially.
Hey, show, what's up?
Hey!
I didn't know you guys can hear me.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Shit! No. I was looking to see if you were showing up in the chat. I didn't see you. Yo, welcome, sir. It's good to see you. I'm waiting to get into your room. It looks like it's packed.
Oh boy.
Shit, man. At least buy the guy a drink before he goes to his room.
You know, bring a case
of
beer.
There's a lot of noodles in here anyway.
True, no doubt. Show, what were you saying?
Nothing.
Well, fuck. Well. It's good to be back.
Somebody on this team is on the other team is squidbagged me, so I had to do it right back.
Please, please do that with my compliments, please. Fuck all that noise. Who do you think they are? Knuckle Doo?
Yeah.
Oh.
I got second place, ladies and
gentlemen. Oh my god.
I don't know. Is this fucker winning like a quarter of a billion?
As I.
Oh my god.
he like earned the right to fucking squid bag.
He thinks he's pro. He ain't ready for the pro leagues yet.
he ain't about that life just yet.
He ain't ready for that shit. He ain't punk level.
Squid bagging sounds like actual thing. Sounds like a thing kids actually do these days. Oof. On the streets.
Wouldn't surprise me.
Hello, Ramses.
Hello.
Hi, Ramses.
Oh, here he is.
Hey, Ramses.
Welcome, sir.
Hi.
I'm welcome. I would play right now, but I realized one thing. I left the game gear uncharged. Yeah.
Oh, hey, whoops, somebody fucked up.
Oh,
toast. Yep.
Mine's been charging up for months.
Actually, no, it's actually...
You don't have a nearby socket you could hook it into, Ramses, or...?
No, and even then, just like, you know, it's connecting everything, because I'm actually not using my... I'm using
that wasn't a trade, right, come on.
I was like, I'm not gonna fucking bother right now. Just, like, another time I'll play with you guys. I came by to say hi.
Hey. All right.
You have a good night, sir.
Hey. Thanks for stopping by.
Let's go.
Dude, what? Should have killed that dude.
Let's do this.
I thought I'd stop by and say hi.
No, man. Well, it's good to hear your voice, man. It's good to have you on deck, man.
It's nice hearing from you.
All right. Well, unless you guys want me to stay here for a little bit, I don't mind.
Oh, no one's kicking you out. Jesus.
It's cool.
But yeah, man. So I guess that Power Rangers live action movie was met with I guess even keel. Like, some people hated it, some people liked it. A lot of people wanted to go get Krispy Kreme afterwards.
Hey, I think it was a bit better than what people expected. I mean, because it seemed like a bit more positive than negative.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. From what I've heard, it ranged from average to positive reviews. So.
Which is okay in my book. Since
you
I'm
need to reboot your shit, bro, because it's not letting you in.
I'm in now.
Oh, there you go.
I don't know what to say, bro. Well, I only had to sit through two fucking waiting periods.
I don't know why I didn't let you in the last match.
Hey, bro, I don't know. I don't know. The noodles are keeping me out, bro. They're keeping me free.
Man, let's do this shit.
Woohoo! Let's go, guys.
So, anybody see Fated
the
Furious?
Yo, I'll probably see it next weekend.
Maybe. I'll be seeing that tonight, so...
Ooh, the fates.
I can't see it right now. I got bills to pay.
Yeah.
Have you seen it, Ramses?
My show's team? No way. No way.
Excuse me. I might go see it tomorrow, because I got
no problem. I'm just waiting for the next movie, The Fast and the Furious.
That was it. It's terrible. Why would you wish that on yourself?
Well,
Yazzie, your puns make me furious, sir.
Well, I was gonna say, I got that from because they made an SNL sketch with Bambi with the Fast and Furious.
Oh, crap. Like, it's like.
They missed an opportunity to make that pun, though.
Is it also a Sonic crossover?
No, but gross. It's the one where Vin Diesel's bumper is like.
Let's talk about Sonic for a fucking second.
What am I saying?
Let me tell you something. I'm kind of done with that guy. I'm done with the fandom. I'm done with the character. Well, it's over. What? The honeymoon is over, man. I'm just done. For some reason, like, I don't know when it became, like...
What triggered you? What's going on?
I don't know. What? Just, like, I'm just done. I didn't realize, like... I don't know if it was, like, a furry... A furry,
oh, God damn it. God. I don't even know what you're talking about.
Son of the Hedgehog.
Jesus, fuck.
Sorry, man. I thought...
Ignore the fandom. Just...
No. Just ruined it for me, man. I used to be cool platformers, and then there was, like, this just fucking fan base that, Come at me, bro.
I take that back. Fast to the Furry, is that Sonic 06?
Look, Sonic Mania will come out at... Sonic Mania will come out, and you'll be okay with the character again.
Oh! Woo! Johnson, baby! Got your ass!
Sonic Mania actually out?
Sonic Mania actually describes the fandom, so you do not want anything to do with that.
What the fuck just happened?
I don't know. It seems like Sonic Mania seems like it's going to be great. So
I mean, it looks good. It looks promising, and it is going back to the well. And I'm hoping that it is really good. But I've just seen too much fucking nasty fucking fan art of Sonic, and it's like, oh, this is ruined for me. this is over.
We said the same thing about Sonic Adventure, Sonic the Hedgehog 4, and that was kind of meh.
So don't tell me you came across Sonic 2.
But
I wasn't trying.
All right. But Sonic 4 was made by Sonic Team, wasn't it?
No, it wasn't. They've been gone for a long time.
It was made by Sega, wasn't it? Well, Sonic Mania is more of a fan project.
Sonic without Yuji Naka, though, man, it has suffered.
Yeah. Oh,
what the fuck?
Well, he quit after in 06, man. It was a glorious burn.
Dude, I was about to say.
I don't know. My motto is...
He said to Sega, fuck you, when they were working on 06.
Oh, did he really? Yeah. Oh, shit.
Sonic 06 is very notorious, and they wanted to push the game out for its anniversary, and just left. He left early in it, too.
Yeah. I mean, it's a big middle finger to his legacy, so I can't blame him for feeling that way.
Yeah.
I understand. Oh, by the way, somehow I lost the connection.
Oh,
so.
Xavier, man, your internet is still Fisher Price?
Oh, no. Fisher Price is the damn servers.
Yo, the bootings.
Yeah, yo. Nintendo servers are Fisher Price.
Oh, they certainly are. That's all right. We'll be paying for them soon. Drink it in. It better be improved. That's all I know.
The cynical side of me says that's not going to help any.
Oh, we'll see.
Oh yeah.
Yo, Mouses, what dark corners of the internet have you been exploring? You kind of have to actively search for that kind of stuff. No, you know, I have to look for pictures sometimes for video games and stuff like that. And for like collages and stuff like that. And for layouts and stuff like that for streams. So I'm not trying to actively look for like Sonic getting cornholed by Knuckles, but you know, it comes up. It comes up often.
Jesus Christ.
And I was like,
that's
really?
That's why, Sober, you put the safe surf option on.
Robin got your ass, but you got me.
So, bro, I'm just surprised.
Jeez, at the same time we were talking, we killed each other anyway.
All right, look, man. Look, that's it.
So, bro, I'm just surprised that Sonic gave you blue balls faster than the Smurfs movie did.
Oh, fuck Violet. That. Oh, that latest Smurfs movie, man. That latest Smurfs movie,
that
guy.
I'll not file
Guzzy, that. Guzzy, that pun made me feel the blues from it,
man. No, fuck you. I will not file that one.
Guzzy, Smurf you, bro. Smurf you.
You know, it's kind of fitting considering the color of
Fuck!
Pain. Pain in this match.
Ah, shit.
Woo! Set your ass down, Noodle!
Oh, goodbye. Ink Strike going in.
I don't know. In general, I try not to let a fandom ruin my...
yeah, usually I don't either. And I'll still play in Sonic Mania when it comes out. My wife wants it, so...
I mean,
we'll probably end up getting it for that reason alone.
Is there a demo already out?
Pay for me.
Johnson, what's happening, baby?
I used to like anime.
Well, I used to like anime back when it was cool and not a mistake.
Oh, boy. Trump is supposed to save it, man. It's supposed to make it great again.
Trump!
But Trump, although, Sean, I think the last anime you and me really enjoyed was like RE0.
RE0?
The Hill's best anime.
Yep. Was it Rim or was it Ram? That was
Rim and Ram. Yeah.
Yeah.
The maid.
Oh!
The little blue and red Oni girls or something like that.
Yeah.
The blue one is the one that matters. No one cares for the red hair.
Yeah, Rim.
I've never watched it.
Oh, jeez.
That's
waifu. It seems.
Best way.
Oh, fuck, a dog!
Yeah, she is, actually.
But when I was because of that one part, I have yet to watch the show. Shit.
It's a damn good show.
When I've heard good shows as of late, I've heard like, the show I've heard nothing but praise for is Konosuba.
What was that? Whoa, Xavier, I swear to God, fix your shit, bro. Fix your
shit. Fuck! Johnson, goddamn you!
What? Konosuba, like, lampoons, like, the, you know, like, RPG, and, like, you know, MMO genre.
Getting shit pushed.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't tell me that was you again.
It's pretty much a parody anime of that anime trend of modern day.
Fuck you!
Modern
who
day
is that?
Boo goes
fucking show,
to a,
God
like,
damn it.
Fantasy world.
But it's actually pretty funny and creative though.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm sorry not to cut you off. When I killed Xavier,
I had him.
His body exploded, right. and you see like his gun shooting like in the middle of the air.
Even though I may die, my gun will continue to fight for me.
That ghost, bro. the ghost of.
But you're saying? I was fine.
Yeah.
Another anime, if you have the chance to watch it, it's a short show called Aka 13. Mm. It's like a lighthearted political thriller.
Hmm. Man, it's on Crunchyroll.
Should be.
All I know is the.
It's also one.
Go ahead. I was gonna say all I know is. Oh no, it's the prequel for fucking Astro Boys just started. Adam,
the opening is amazing.
I need to get on that. Show introduced that to me just the other day. I was like, get the fuck out of here. That's a thing? Yo, that's crazy.
It's that one because it's Urasawa, man.
Urasawa, baby. That's why I'm hoping to make it'll adapt Pluto eventually, but this is really cool. That's really fucking cool,
oh,
man.
Boy, fuck.
The fact that the show even exists already has my attention.
Oh, yeah.
Come on.
Ah, shit.
Let's go. Let's cook, baby.
Full Metal Panic has been delayed to fall, allegedly.
Oh yeah, shit, that's right, that's coming out.
Well, it got pushed back, so.
As long as it comes out, though, I suppose.
If it does.
It's a continuation, correct?
It's the next set of novels and everything.
Okay.
Yeah, finally, after so many years.
But it's like they're not going to retread over the old material, correct?
Nah, they
wouldn't
have. It's a continuation, so. Okay. Yeah, they wouldn't have a reason to go back and redo it anyway, so.
I mean, they might do a quick clip show in the beginning to, you know, retread things, because it's been a long-ass time.
Yeah, that could be possible. I can see that.
So many things to watch.
That's overall,
Not too many good ones, though, to watch.
But there's even, like, old stuff that I want to catch up on.
Yeah, the backlog's impossible to fucking get caught up on. It's crazy.
Yeah. You would know.
God damn, I'll tell you. Yo, fucking LOT. Oh, is it LOGH, man?
Oh RIP. My god, Bucket!
I'm gonna speak for Sean and I'm gonna say fuck you, so bro.
You're welcome. I'm so behind on all my shows, though. I'm so upset. I was like, I'm not giving up on them, but I'm probably giving up on doing Quiet as Kept because I am so fucking behind. And every time I try to set out to do it, the world fucking plots against me.
Woo! Oh, shit!
I know, right? It's nuts!
I know that feeling.
Have you seen the second Voltron, though?
Voltron season? Yeah, I saw that. That's fucking great.
MZ has also seen that because he did a stream on that. Yeah, plug.
Oh yeah, I know. That's right. Yeah, shout outs to Shin Station Europe. They did a collabo stream with Ramses about the Voltron season 2. So you guys can run that back over on tinyurl.com/ShinStationEU if you guys missed it. The archives nice. Up. You guys can check out all the commentary over there. Did they finish the whole show?
Oh yeah, they.
I'm pretty sure they did.
2 days.
Yeah.
It's really quick to go through, man. All those seasons of Voltron go by like nothing.
So the new show's actually pretty good, huh?
Oh, yeah, fucking Voltron season 2 is better than 1.
Dude, I sat on the show so much before it came out until I saw that first trailer. I took back my comments. Because I didn't care for the original Voltron because it was a piece of crap.
Yeah.
Does anybody remember the CGI Voltron show?
Yeah, I do.
That's
fuck, we lost.
Third dimension.
God damn it, we lost.
Third dimension, yes.
Did we win? Tell me we won.
What? Was that the show that was on
Nickelodeon? The UPN.
Nope. The one that was on Nickelodeon was
Underpaid Neophytes.
That's Voltron.
Underpaid Neanderthals.
Underpaid Neanderthals, that's it. That's exactly what it means.
UPN.
UPN.
Remember, that was like one of the only places we could watch animes back in.
I know, right? Yep. Like Techno Man? Techno fucking man, dude. The good old days.
It was the 90s, though. So.
That shit used to come on Sunday mornings as I was getting ready to go for church. I'd have to fucking prop up the VCR. It's like, okay, I need you to record this. Then I need you to switch.
Let's not forget, it was also the network with the most sanitized DBZ and Sailor Moon.
Well, that was more so syndication. I know when a lot of UPN channels did carry Sailor Moon and DBZ because it was the only channel that would buy those up. But there were some networks where it would come on other channels, some syndicated areas. But yeah, that's pretty much what it was like over on our end. Our UPN had Sailor Moon and DBZ, especially when DBZ first started. It wasn't even DBZ, it was just Dragon Ball. It was just regular Dragon Ball.
But I think it was on UPN, at least to my knowledge. It was actually more edited than the one that came on Cartoon Network.
Oh, yeah, man.
God, and then there's, that's my Samurai Pizza Cats, and then Reboot. Oh, yes.
Oh, which, the reboot of Reboot is not that great, by the way.
It already aired?
I think it's aired, or...
No,
fuck you! God damn it!
Why bother calling it Reboot? It's called Reboot Square.
Yeah.
Oh, motherfuckers!
Yeah. It's like a weird deviation from the original, though, in my thought.
It's like live action.
Live action stuff in all that, though.
Oh, Christ.
Yeah. You know what? I'm surprised they haven't come up with a new Dragon Quest show yet.
Nah, Dragon Quest is good. It's done.
Because the 90s one is actually pretty decent.
Oh, yeah. I hated that shit. I'm in two minds about that. There was one half that was really good, and then the half that was like...
Dark.
Yeah, there was one half that was like where they looked older. I couldn't stand that shit.
Oh yeah, but where they actually got the better animation.
And it would go to Quest World. That shit was the fucking worst. That CG looked like fucking someone shat it out.
That shit was
terrible, dude.
The wannabe Tron?
Oh yeah, the wannabe Tron is right. That shit looked like somebody made it for $2. And that's talking about back then. That budget must have been all of 5 cents. God damn.
But they got the animation right later on, though.
I know Quentin Flynn was the voice of Johnny Carson. Johnny Quest in one of the incarnations. The guy who does the voice of Raiden in the fucking Metal Gear games.
Well, at least it was better than that one show that was on before.
Oh, you mean the Hanna-Barbera?
God damn it, that was Hanna-Barbera.
Oh my god, almost got me.
Oh!
I can't believe you didn't see me before.
Fuck you! God damn it!
What Hanna-Barbera show?
Johnny Quest.
The
real adventures of Johnny Quest. Which there was nothing real about it.
Yeah, and then before that, it was
And I love Johnny Quest, don't get me fucking wrong. I love the original series. As racist as it is.
That's
a racist as fuck. Yo, Haji, I see you.
Wait, Zobro. Zobro, don't you be race banner as fuck?
Yo, race banner, baby. Yo, the ultimate man. Yo, fucking.
Who got killed in Venture Brothers?
And Venture Brothers, yeah, like early in the first season. That shit was fucking crazy.
Oh, that's right. He was just dragged on like some parachute and kept getting caught in the wind.
That shit fucking died so bad. Oh, fuck that.
Oh, that was so fucked up.
You know what? I'll say this right now. I'm not going to hear any arguments for this. SWAT Cats is still the best Hanna-Barbera cartoon.
It really is. SWAT Cats was the shit.
Great.
Although, I did like, what was another? Dark Water was good, too. If it was little as it less, Dark Water was alright. Yeah, Pirates of Dark Water was good. Yeah.
That was Hanna-Barbera?
Yeah, that was it was Hanna-Barbera.
Oh, I could tell with the animation.
Yo, what about Yogi's fucking arc race, man? Do 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 do. What about Galtar, y'all? No, what the fuck I'm talking about. Yo, don't remember Galtar?
Yes.
It was like their He-Man knockoff. That shit was horrible. What's that?
Nobody's as old as you.
Look, man, it was the 80s, man. The mid-80s, man. I remember Galtar, son.
Oh, you mean the big caveman?
Just look it up. Look up Galtar. Someone is either eating cereal?
I'm eating soup, because me and Cho have been on that soup kick.
Fucking soup, son. Those kettle slow cook kettles.
Oh my god, yo, that soup
amazing.
Yo, that... you're making me hungry.
Oh, 2985, we got James in here now.
Shout out to Ramses. He said Goldtar in the Golden Lands. Thank you, sir. You know what I'm talking about.
It sounds like a gay porno.
Well, hey, man, he had the Golden Lands. He lanced that ass.
Oh my god.
I mean, I'm surprised it's not called Goldtar the Golden Shower.
Hey, man. Just ask Donald Trump, man. Show, man, show. Take it easy. Take it easy. God damn it.
So does anybody
God damn it.
Cartoon?
Oh,
God damn it.
You're full of shit.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. Show's a big fan of Jim Carrey movies. What? Wait, are you talking about the mask?
No, not the mask. That was a good cartoon, actually. I was talking about before Toonami, 3:30. They used to air that horrible-ass Hanna-Barbera Godzilla cartoon.
Oh, yeah, they used to air all sorts of shit.
I'll never let Fred forget about that either.
Oh, I don't let him forget about you because I hate that shit.
I've seen clips of it. It's, oh, God, it's
I used
pretty
to
bad.
Stomach it. I used to stomach it before Toonami. It's like, okay, I can use 30 minutes and I would hate myself every time.
There was I think before that 98 movie came out in theaters, they were doing a whole marathon of the Hanna-Barbera.
I heard the Godzilla cartoon from the 90s, the one based on the movie, was actually good, right?
Yeah, based on the series,
It was the same
because
guys.
Because they went up against, they did the Men in Black series or something, I think.
They did Men in Black, they did Big Guy and Rusty. They did Extreme Ghostbusters.
I think it was Sony Animation or something, was it?
Possibly.
Woo! God damn it!
You know what? I forgot about that show. Big Guy and Rusty. That was the American version of Astro Boy.
Yep.
Fucking.
It was good.
Fuck.
Good. It ended on a cliffhanger that pissed me off.
Die already, you little shit.
I cannot protect this shit from a fucking bucket.
Well, I was gonna say, was the one underrated, like, older Hanna-Barbera one I like is Willy and the Chopper Punch.
Never
that is this one. It is literally kind of like Kirby, but like there's always like chase kind of things, chase kind of like comedy. And it's like,
fuck! Good shit. I earned that shit so fucking bad.
Damn, it makes horn noises to speak and shit. And it's like these four dudes are always trying to like the Chopper Punch. Hence the title. It's like they're always trying to get him or smash him up or something. Only to get smashed themselves or something. And, crash or screw themselves over kind of thing.
Wow.
So it's kind of like,
hey, my team, where the hell y'all at?
Fuck a duck.
Whee! I don't know if Soulborn knows that show anyway.
I do.
What show?
I said it before. Wheelie and the Chocolate Bunch.
I know that show. Yeah. I couldn't get with most of Hanna-Barbera cartoons, man. I couldn't do it. If it had Yogi Bear in it, I gave it a shot. Like, if it was Camp Candy, I think Camp Candy was a Hanna-Barbera show, technically, and that show was awesome.
The thing about that show is when I look at the voice cast too, it's like, you had Frank Welker, then you had what's the name?
Frank Welker was an all Hanna-Barbera.
The guy who used to voice Tigger before he passed on.
He's talking about Paul Winfield.
Yeah, that's it. And then there was also Winnie Lenrip and Don Messick and that thing. And it was like, I kind of recognize all these voices now, way before Transformers or other things now. It's like, this is kind of funny to watch. So, looking back on that one.
Yo, Armor says, when can we expect SBR to play Sun Run, Kagura Peach Beach Splash in your dreams, brother? in your dreams.
That's the water gun one, like Splatoonish kind
of. Oh my god, I'm alright, I dabbled in the waters. A Senran Kagura, I still got it. Maybe I should just sell it on fucking eBay or something. But I dabbled in those waters, and I'm done dabbling.
I'm done dabbling.
Hey, it's not bad. It's poor man's Dynasty Warriors, but it's okay.
Well, the Senran Kagura games are always a little bit like that, and the 2D side-scrolling beat-em-ups on like 3DS and stuff.
Oh yeah.
Yeah,
those scenes, son of a bitch! Who fucking did? God damn it! Armor says Maximilian and his boys played it, which is cool. He can afford all those games. I just got a new car, bro. I have not to pick and choose my battles. I do have some games I plan on getting though over the next couple of months. I gotta get that KOF DLC first and foremost. It's the first fucking thing I'm buying. Rock and all those guys. I gotta get the some of the DLC coming up for Street Fighter V. Oh, god damn it! I'm gonna fucking clap you.
Shit!
Oh my god.
Sober, I've been playing this DLC. Sober, have you played the DLC for Resident Evil 6 yet?
Oh, I haven't played it at all. I'm sure show you have, right? How was it?
Wait,
the DLC for RE6.
You mean
RE7? RE7, let me fix my face.
It's the free DLC, right? Or did the paid DLC release?
The paid one is out. The spring one with Chris is not out yet.
That's what I'm waiting for.
Wait, which one's the current paid one?
There's like two of them. And each one has got like three things to it.
Stupid.
Oh, I love it when you people try to get me with the mine when they know I got Bomb Sniffer.
Oh, God.
Oh.
That's terrible.
Well, it almost kind of
worked. Speaking of fighting games, I'm about to...
Strikes love the place.
And I was pinning you down.
Fuck! God damn it!
It's almost like we're working our ink strikes together.
Fuck it, James! You know? God damn it, James!
A large one, here comes Shield.
Fucking them up. They got nowhere to go.
Just fuck them up. Push the shit in, come on!
Speaking of fighting games, allegedly there was a trademark for a possible Persona 5 Arena.
Oh, I don't doubt it. I don't fucking doubt it. That's a license to print money in Japan.
Oh yeah. They trademark like four fucking webpages. Oh, yeah.
let's just hope Europe doesn't get as shafted with that.
Oh, they will.
I can always import it.
No. What? Oh yeah.
Woo! James, I got your ass. You got me though.
Because because PS4 Arena was region locked.
Push me. Push.
Was it for just Japan though in the US or was it?
It was overseas, which pissed Europeans off a lot since it's like.
It's one of the rare few PS3 you get.
Atlas doesn't have a branch in Europe.
Atlas is strange, man. I still fucking am a little miffed at the bullshit they pulled.
But here's
Jesus Christ!
But so, bro, his ring.
Stuff.
Do you think it's an Atlas thing or do you think it's a Sega thing? Because remember, it could be a Sega thing.
Because
remember, let's not forget what happened with Phantasy Star a couple of years ago.
Oh, yeah. They've been pretty stupid.
The Shining Force.
Shining Force 3 on the Saturn. I was like, wow, you're stopping people from fucking streaming that? Why? That game hasn't even been on the market.
If it's any consolation, it seems like it's not being enforced.
Wow.
Like, they're not doing shit to enforce it.
You mean the 7-7 rule?
Yeah. They're not doing shit to enforce it, so it's like...
Yeah, but it's not that big to begin with, though.
Yeah.
Just saying, the people watching, they're watching with the interest of getting the game themselves and going through it themselves. Granted, I can understand plot points within the first month. If you want to stop people from doing it for the first month and say, yo, after the first month, we don't give a fuck. You know, put a fucking due date on that shit. It's like, I know it's hard to keep this in a lid on this, but if you're a fan of these games, would you do us a favor and not do this until this date? And it's like, okay, that's cool. When I first saw the news, I thought it was an actual 7-7 was an actual real date. And it's like, no, that's an in-game date. Oh, what the fuck? So
go ahead.
No, go ahead. What were we gonna say?
I was gonna say I played the game over halfway through it, but. For some reason, because I played Persona 3 and 4, but for some reason they're not using actual date for the in-game, you know, dates and everything. Because it takes place a couple of years after Persona 4, and it's said in the game how many years it is, but they're not using a real date for some reason.
Well, they're using the day and the month and day to keep track of the game, but it's like, if the year-wise it's nebulous, it's 20XX.
Fuck!
But I'm saying, based on the actual like background information, everything, you know exactly how many years it is after Persona 4, which was like 2011.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm saying it's kind of weird that they're doing that. So. Atlas.
I guess it's because it's kind of I don't know. It's.
I mean, is it relevant in the end? But I mean,
yeah.
I'm just saying they haven't done it in the previous game, so why do it here? That's why.
Reasons, make money. I don't know. Oh shit! I just fell off the stage. How the fuck you do that?
I mean, when you post an exact year where your game takes place, you always run the risk of doing dating it.
Yeah, they shouldn't do that. They should just keep the calendar nebulous.
Well, the thing is, in the previous two games, those games were set in the future.
They had an exact year.
But when this game comes out, it was set in the year it comes out. So I guess maybe that's why.
Woo! Got you, Wes!
And it's also kind of weird because it's like, I think another reason is like, apparently, because Persona 5 was originally planned for like years ago. I think its original date was like planned for like 2014, but it kept being pushed back. So it's like,
gotcha, bitch.
Fucking hell. Purple dominated this match.
Yeah, the hell we did. Let's go.
So,
going back to my point. Sorry to interrupt, but if you're gonna do all these like all these domain names and everything, they might need to find a new developer for Persona 5 Dancing because the original developer went bankrupt a month ago.
Oh shit!
Was it Dingo Entertainment? No offense, move.
That's if they
Dingo Entertainment.
Dingo Entertainment. Dingo. Dingo Inc. That's
Dingo ate their baby, bro. They got fucked. No one bought their game, apparently, for them to go out of business like that, man. That's
it did pretty well, and they also made the Hatsune Miku games.
Oh, damn. How did they go broke?
They made some of them, but they went bankrupt.
Damn. Somebody mismanaged those funds. Oh, well.
Someone ran off with the money.
Probably Sega.
Oh, so you dipped out?
Yeah, Sega. I mean, they were like they were a subcontractor. They weren't owned by Sega.
A third party company like Arc System works for.
Aren't they in house though? Aren't they?
Oh yeah, that's true. I forgot about that. Yeah, they're in house too. That's right. Mm-hmm. Totally forgot, man.
Speaking of which, when is that second? What is it? Second Rev.
It's coming out in June.
Yeah, I think it actually comes out here. It's already out in Japan, right?
It's about to come out.
Yeah, I think it actually comes out here in May. Like, late May. I could be wrong.
In May 25th, that was May or June, one of those dates.
Fuck a duck.
Hey, man, if only I could get more Dizzy in the story, I'm good.
And hopefully they add a lot more content for people who are, for the characters they added with DLC prior.
But I think if it's like a $20 upgrade, I might as well just upgrade my dick over now.
Son of a bitch! Revelator? Guilty Gear? Guilty Gear Zerd?
Second Rev, which is Rev 2, DLC that's going to come out.
But yeah, they said there's like a cheat. There's like you could upgrade digitally for just, you know, the Revelator version, so.
That's good.
I mean, if it's $20, not a bad price for an upgrade.
Yeah, that's what I plan on buying. Because I already bought the game digitally already. So.
I'm just not sure how much I'll use the new characters, that's all.
Well, I'll use the fuck out of Biken.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, if you want to buy Revelator now, it's $20 on Amazon.
Gotcha again!
I never was much of a Biken player.
Well, she could be different now, so. Yeah. It's been quite a few years. Hey man, I just wish Gabriel was playable.
Yeah, That's the thing. It's like everyone, every character wants.
No. Well, I was gonna say, but then again, we never got Jubei playable in the Blaze movie.
Yep. Yeah, we never got Jubei.
You should never play with Jubei, and you should never play with Yoda in any game. Just they're too small. They're too small. Oh my gosh.
Whew, I'm on fire tonight.
We have Platinum in Blaze Blue,
worst character ever. except the Kyle's that character.
I still gotta play the new Blaze Blue. I got
Central
DLC.
Fiction? Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's I got the my
what the DLC fuck?
free thanks to us Arc System Works. I got a free Twitter thing.
That's good.
Nice.
Yeah, it's the only thing I ever win.
You gotta scrape out what you can.
Hey,
bro.
At least it's more than me.
I mean, it's only a $5 DLC for a game I don't even have, but hey.
Hey, whatever works.
Well, that was an ass whipping.
Hey, that just means when you get Blazeful, you can play as the genderbender waifu.
Yep.
Who? What character?
My.
She's from a side story manga that's like one. She's like one of the friends in the world from school. Oh,
she's a crossdresser. Crossdressing.
No, she's a Ranma. She got Ranma.
Oh, so she turns into a guy and turns into a girl?
No. Well, she started off as a guy,
uh-huh.
But then through some kind of strange shit, she turned to a girl permanently.
Oh, sorry. Sorry about that, guy. Lost that penis, man. It's over. Mm-hmm. He's Caitlyn now.
I was just about to say she,
Bruce is over. Jennered. Yeah, you pulled the Jenner? Oh, no. Accidentally? That's fucked up. That should be a choice. Oh, yeah. Oh! Oh! Who the fuck is this guy?
But yeah, Central Fiction is great. And I...
Central Fiction, I need to get my hands on that.
The new characters and mechanics they added are really good.
They add a character from the light novel games, X-Blaze.
That's right. Oh!
Yep.
Oh, no.
Yep.
Oh, no, we're not playing this fucking game today.
Also, they added from kind of like a spin-off manga as well. A spin-off... weird... I don't know. They add a lot of, like, weird, obscure characters.
At least they're adding characters from, like, other forms of fiction for BlazBlue, so that's cool.
Well, they're still the same universe, so...
Yeah, it's in the same universe, just different.
Oh, I just heard, man, and is like, next to none of y'all probably read this book. I was trying to get away, bro, What other option did I have? To fight? Yeah, that's a laugh.
What did Blade say?
and if you care about that sort of thing in fighting games, they actually wrap up... They actually managed to nicely wrap up this Blade story in Central Fiction.
Oh, that's cool.
I was just on top of the hill, Georgie.
Clap his ass.
I had the higher ground.
That was next to you when I died.
You wrapped up the story.
He just came up the ramp and just like ran into my knee.
I was gonna say after this.
Oh wow! Thanks.
fucking ass! God damn it!
Oh! God, I can't fucking use a nuke to save my goddamn life.
After the second Revelator game, because seems like both BlazBlue and Guilty Gear story is gonna be wrapped up. Shit. So.
Man, they will never fucking cross BlazBlue and Guilty Gear over, will they? Woo!
They said they wanted to.
No, the closest thing they were was this April Fool's thing that they did.
Yeah,
this year.
I saw that. Oh. I saw that. That was a little bit mean spirited. I think eventually they will, but it may be some time before they do.
A few of the dose designs they showed actually looked kind of good.
Well, I think 2 years ago, Daisuke Shimotani said he'd like to do a crossover. Go with what the plots were done for both games.
Yo, shout outs to Doc. I see you in the chat. He said he went out to dinner. He's back. Hope dinner was good to you.
He saw
your name, man. Him and Ali saw your name, man. It's your name, bro. Your name.
I just wonder what they're going to do graphics-wise if they do a crossover.
Oh, it's going to be based on the Guilty Gear engine. I'm almost pretty sure that. I mean, that's the next level. A fun fact about Arc System Works: ever since they started, their line art comes based off of 3D models they've always built of the characters, going all the way back to the original Guilty Gear. So they base the line off of that, and that's why the models kind of blend seamlessly into. The animation seems so seamless in Guilty Gear Zerd is because they've been using 3D models the whole time. Jesus Christ.
If I remember correctly, Daisuke Shibutani, he worked on some of the BlazBlue games.
He definitely did the music for a lot in the music for them.
Yeah, he definitely worked on the music. And he's also an artist, and he also is a voice actor, so he's a...
Well, not anymore as a voice actor.
How do we still have this one Japanese player?
Oh man, this guy's hanging in there. It's like, I want to play with Gaijins because I don't give a fuck.
Hey, he's persistent.
Oh yeah.
He's sticking around, man. Look at this guy. Good shit. Who are these fucking asshole Gaijin I'm stuck with? Almro, no, we haven't talked about the Street Fighter EX thing yet, but it's pretty cool that proof of concept was actually more fact than bullshit for for April Fool's Day. So
it's just you gotta have balls to release something like that on April Fool's.
Well, more developers actually, you know, end with a joke on April Fool's Day, though.
That's the worst day of the fucking year.
Can't trust shit.
Can't trust nothing. I can't stand that fucking day. So who, I wanted to ask, anybody here, keep up with anything Star Wars at all? No one?
What specifically?
Think that Japanese player?
Celebration last
how
week.
How is that not a trade bullshit,
James? I mean, the only thing I know is a new trailer for Last Jedi. That's about it.
Yeah. They've been releasing books since Disney got the license. They've been releasing books, and they released a book a while ago called Lost Stars, which is kind of a YA novel about two star-crossed lovers that end up fighting on the opposite sides of the war. It takes you through, like, the...
Ah, that's what you get, James.
Takes you through the entire original trilogy. It seemed very like anime when I read the book, and I was like, yo, this is anime as fuck. Yep. Are they ever going to, like, do something with this? And they just announced at Celebration they're making a manga of it. So I was like, oh, that's fucking cool.
Speaking of Star Wars books, I've actually got the form book. I'm going to read that sometime.
Sure. I listened to the audiobook of Lost Stars, and I thought it was really cool.
I
haven't read that one. I just got the form one because I want to see what they do with it.
Actually, I'm listening to Lost Life Kit right now.
I need to get my hands on it. I just got a... What book did I get my hands on? Lords of the Sith. Too. Yeah, Bloodline is also written by Claudia Gray, who wrote Lost Stars. She wrote Lost Stars before Bloodline, and I've been meaning to get my hands on that.
Sorry to go, it's not a Star Wars thing, but the new Battlefront 2 game coming out?
Hey, listen, I might get fooled into buying it.
And it might have a VR, from what some reason
no doubt. I'm getting it on PC, though. I'm going to put that on the table right now. I'm not getting it on PS4, so...
Joy. That means I can play with you.
There you go.
Well, one thing I want to point out, though, because it actually has a story, and interestingly enough, it's written by the guy who wrote Spec Ops: The Line.
Fuck! Oh, wow. Of course, that's you.
Actually, a good game too.
It is a good game, but here's the thing.
Fucking guts you.
There are, but here's the funny thing: there are two writers for Spec Ops: The Line. One of them was the same guy who wrote Fear and the Resident Evil 7. But other guy that wrote Spec Ops: The Line, he's working on Battlefront 2.
God, there's such a delay with James. I swear to God. There's such a fucking delay with him. You kill him, he explodes like a second later.
Lag powers. Yo, it happens every time I try to take on Robin. I fucking die.
So apparently Rebels Season 4 is it, and they're probably going to work on something else.
The Rebels season, which is fine. I hope that series ends parallel to A New Hope. Everybody keeps saying, oh, it's going to end right before Rogue One. It's like, that's stupid. They already said they're going to fucking show their part in the Battle of Scarif, because you see the ghosts during Rogue One. So it's like, I want to see the perspective of what happened during that fight. I want to see what goes on with them during the whole battle with the Death Star. I hope the series actually goes all the way up to when the Death Star gets blown up for the first time. That'd be really cool. But if it ends before then, I'm going to be a little miffed.
I just hope... No, the ending I wanted to throw Hondo off the airlock.
Oh, hopefully.
Fuck that guy.
Hondo.
Fuck that guy.
Yo, Hondo, he's got to go, huh?
Yeah, he's gotta get like, okay, you're annoying.
He's the
worst aspect
got him.
Of the Clone Wars. Oh, yeah, he is. He's like, wow. Wait a minute. Like, oh, it's Hondo episode, cringe.
The show on my team, thank God I can breathe easy.
Although I heard that Obi-Wan thing from,
don't expect the miracles.
Oh, man, look.
Pull your weight, bitch.
Look, man, I'm gonna try. I'm gonna fucking try.
I know you're on Show's team, you're on me and Show are on the same team.
Oh my God, thank Christ.
Yeah.
Alright, yo, that's guaranteed. I'm working.
I haven't seen the parts of season 3 yet, but I heard the Obi-Wan part was in Rebels, actually pretty good.
Yeah, yeah.
Try to get this fucker before he exudes.
I heard it's pretty good too.
It was simple, and I was like, wow, that works.
It was very samurai-like, which I thought was really cool, as it should be, because Obi-Wan's an older dude now. He shouldn't be getting into no flippy battles. Flippy battles? Yo, I'm flipping and I'm twirling my lightsaber. No, man, he's fucking 60, bro.
We'll say when Rebels is finished, it's like the Star Wars animated stuff can move on from Dave Filoni.
So oh, Dave Filoni sounds like he's going to be involved with the next series, according to what he said at Celebration.
He's off Rebels now.
He's been off Rebels because he's been working on the next series. He may be helping to produce a TV show, though. That's the rumor. Yeah, an actual live-action TV series might be being made.
I just hope Man of Action is nowhere near. So fuck them.
Man of Action from Marvel? Yo, fuck that. That's Jeff Loeb, right?
That's fucking it.
It's still Disney, though.
Man of Action is Disney now?
Well, they're working on the Disney animated stuff, so...
Hey, James, how you doing, baby? Oh, fuck!
Is in Man of Action the Ben 10 guys?
Yeah, they did Ben 10 and Generator X.
So what's your problem with them?
Well, they also did Ultimate Spider-Man. They did the Hulk, the Hulkbuster show.
I think that has to deal with the person who wrote the show, because I know the person who's head of the Marvel
show. I saved you.
Does not like any overarching stories.
That's Jeff Loeb. EMH got canceled this event.
He's also part of Man of Action.
Let's get this Japanese guy.
Woo!
He's got Izuka.
Busted that motherfucker in his ass.
I don't like him either because he ruined heroes for me.
But he's doing a decent job for the most part on the Marvel Netflix shows.
Yeah, what's that now?
They brought Ben 10 again.
Yeah, they brought it back. Yeah, I heard about that. It's a reboot.
And I heard it. Crap.
Is it still going to be voiced by Yuri Lowenthal?
No, Tara Strong. When he was a kid, he was Tara Strong.
Oh, for real? Yo, Mal says SBR ain't wasting time getting. Sorry, SBR ain't wasting time getting on top of Show's shoulders.
He doesn't even hide the fact, right?
It's fucking true. It's fucking true.
He doesn't even hide the fact.
I'll take my third place. I'll take third place. Fuck it.
Hey, I'm in. Are buckling.
Jesus.
Oh my god.
I'm fucking dying. Oh my god. Want to remind you guys that Show is streaming over on his channel, twitch.tv/ShojiRamaro. Make sure to check him out over in twitch.tv/ShojiRamaro and hitbox.tv/ShojiRamaro. Are you streaming on a YouTube show?
No.
Oh well, is that pretty much done on Restream? YouTube capabilities is just fucked.
Apparently I got blocked out for 3 months.
Oh wow!
I was never given an email or anything. So I was like, okay, what?
Yeah, right. You go there and you just got fucked. It's like you got to click OK on this message. Can't stream for 3 months. It's like, what the fuck? It's those YouTube heroes, man. I don't know if y'all know about that, but YouTube has been appointing people to do their fucking shit for them. And oh, you broke community guidelines. Guess what? You're fucked. You have to, But you can still upload videos, though. That's the fucking thing. Without getting barred like that. I still upload my archives.
The funny thing is, I'm getting in trouble is because I'm actually playing YouTube video.
Oh, wow. Ain't that stupid?
I'm banned off of YouTube because I played a YouTube video?
You would imagine you wouldn't be, but here we are.
This is the same YouTube that Ubisoft uploaded a video of their own. They still got ID.
They got ID flag. Oh, yeah, because they didn't white flag themselves.
YouTube has been fucking up a lot lately, which I mean, the sky is blue. What else?
But why doesn't YouTube actually have the last couple years?
Yo, Austin.
What is YouTube TV?
Hey, what's up?
Hey, what's happening?
For a while, I just haven't.
Awesome, man. It's good to see you, man. Yeah. Good shit.
Yo.
Because YouTube thinks that just giving all your, like, security things to algorithms and stuff is going to solve everything. Right.
No. Yeah. It's not even about that. It's, like, you know, giving the guys with the big corporations, you know, all the free pass they want.
Yeah.
Not give a shit about anything else, you know. You know, you think a company, you know, that has a decent search engine might, you know, keep better track of things, but nope.
No. Google just wants the money. So much. As long as they get the money, they don't give a fuck.
Well, it's different. I mean, Google search and everything isn't too bad, but the old different branches have different problems, but YouTube is full of crap, though. So.
Shit!
Oh, yeah, it can be full of crap, but like, I wish they would throw some balls about Google Fiber and expanding it because goddamn AT&T and Comcast are getting
stonewalling
them.
That's an FCC thing, man. Good luck with that.
Uh-huh. Oh god,
especially with the new head.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that fucker? Oh my god, yeah, the things are gonna get jammed up for fucking 4 years. Guaranteed. Oh, god.
Hey, yeah.
And let Comcast and AT&T do whatever the fuck they want, and it's gonna be like, people are gonna get raped because of it. Shitty internet for the shitty price.
Yeah.
Hey, man, it's what this country deserves these days.
No.
I don't say it deserves it. Well, I mean, granted, there were idiots that voted for the wrong candidate, but,
Well, they're
the coffee right now, and they're like, oh, shit, we should go.
Both were pretty bad, but one worse than the other.
Yeah.
Ways.
Yeah.
Hey, man, but shit can always change.
Fuck! Austin, good shit.
Yep. We could all... How you been doing? We could all be dead tomorrow.
I mean, what's the name of that lizard god again? Like Zolf or something?
I have no idea.
What's the name of that lizard cult or something?
Lizard cult?
Lizard squad or what?
Are you talking about fucking Scientology or what?
No. What's the name of that sober. What's the name of that cult from Parks and Rec?
I forget. I know what you're talking about. Then.
Yeah,
oh my god.
Was it Zork or something?
I wish I did that. Oh my god.
Oh no, I'm sorry. I love best shows.
Parks and Rec is not on Netflix, is it?
It is.
Oh, okay.
You well, should that, watch it just for Rob Swanson.
That's another thing for the backlog. I've been kind of watching Always Sunny.
Yeah, Always Sunny is that.
You cannot go wrong with that show.
I need to get on top of that. Yo, damn, who is this guy from Japan? He's still rolling with us with this bucket and shit.
That's fine. I'm gonna kill him again.
Oh my god.
Don't make that name funny.
Oh, okay. Ramsey's got so, bro. Zorp the Surveyor.
Zorp the Surveyor. That's great.
That's hilarious. The Zorp
the Zorp. Zorp the Surveyor. Oh my god. They were busting on Scientology so hard in that episode.
And prepare for the apocalypse.
Oh my god.
It's like, oh, you need to buy these handmade flutes? Sure, take my credit card, because it's going to be useless tomorrow.
Oh. Fucking foolishness.
The look on Ron Swanson's face.
Motherfuckers got.
Yeah. Oh god. Yeah,
it cracks me up how everyone is using the same fucking weapon. So that's why we got so many ink strikes.
Yeah, and that's what I'm hoping Splatoon 2 does better. It gives more incentive. It gives more incentive to do different weapons.
Well, the ink strikes is no longer concentrated like that. It's more like Macross missiles now. So unless they change it back to the classic, the classic ink strike is still will be available in the full game. Yeah, it could be.
I figured that's a different weapon entirely. Yeah.
That's just like a that's a variation. Shit. I think it does a variation, that kind of thing, that one.
All I know is they're gonna have esports with Splatoon now. Esports!
And also Mario Kart 8 Deluxe is something now.
That's right, baby. I can't wait to get mine next week!
Speaking of esports, Windjam is coming out.
Oh, yeah, speaking of. Yeah. What's that?
Yeah. Nah, Windjam
is for the PS4.
I don't know.
That's a good question.
Didn't I hear that it's been kind of. Some people have received, like, that's been kind of getting poor netcode, like, expectations.
Oh, pity.
Like, the company that is working on it's not that known for good netcodes.
Yeah, got...
Jeez.
You got greedy.
Oh, you bitch! God damn it! You got greedy. Oh my god.
I mean, couldn't you just get, like, an Ironclad Galaxy or something to do it?
Yeah, I gotta get out of here.
Because I heard that recent, like, Garo port.
The Russians cut!
Well, received. With it.
What's that, Iron Galaxy?
Iron Galaxy, doing, Windjammers?
No, Garo.
Yeah, that Garo port, that recent Garo port.
That was Iron Galaxy? Oh, Mark shit. Johnson, I saw you! I saw you.
I was trying to port the show.
Oh shit, support.
Oh boy.
Woo! Austin, okay. God damn it!
Shit.
Rush!
Oh my god, I'm just covering up all the shit here. Oh, look at this guy. Oh, damn it, I swear to god. You shoot the shit out of James, but he doesn't die.
He's got that super armor. Woo!
Oh yeah, the new Bill Nye Science Guy show came on Netflix.
Oh, did?
Oh yeah, that's right.
It just released.
Oh, yo, shout out to Natalie. She's writing in Doc's place on the chat. She says, Doc and I want MK Deluxe so bad, but we can't find a Switch. Hopefully there'll be a new push for Switches by that time.
I thought he had multiple personalities.
Shout out to Natalie. Hopefully they have another push, because I know in other countries...
Doc is over here split.
Yo, he's split.
He's leading.
Oh, and no.
If you don't mind waiting a bit, I suppose you could get one of those bundles from GameStop.
But the I know that there's gonna be an official Mario Kart 8 Deluxe bundle outside of the United States. I wish they would do that here too. When it comes to bundling Mario Kart 8 with the Switch.
The thing with the Switch is it's almost stopping someone from importing one. It's like, you need to make sure it's you have a different power adapter, and that's it pretty much.
That's with every system, though. You port a PS3 for Japan, they all have different power converters anyways.
No, but because this one is like external, that kind of thing, so it's like all your stuff inside isn't really anything at all, you know? The power brick on the outside.
Oh.
Shout out to Varnus, he had to deal with that. He bought a Switch from here in America, but he left his plug behind because he knew he couldn't use it in Australia, so he has a charge cord for the Switch in the form of a USB cord because he got a Pro with it. So it comes with a USB charger cord, so he can charge up the Switch. But he can't use the dock until he gets an actual AC adapter for him. Which I'm sure he got one off of Amazon. Sure, after he got back.
Shouldn't cost too much. Yeah.
Is it like a standardized one? Is it like a proprietary thing?
It might be a proprietary. No, it should be standardized. USB-C. It's USB-C, so it's generic enough, yeah. What? Okay. The fuck?
Still, like, I kind of want to lessen the risk of accidentally causing, like a blowout.
Fair enough.
Woo! Let's go.
Plus, I can be patient.
I mean, Switch is not going anywhere.
Yeah.
I like the NES Classic.
I would imagine by the time Splatoon 2 comes out, they're gonna have plenty on the wall. Plenty available.
NES Classic thing, that was pretty
I'm not sure if I brought it up earlier, but compared to like Sony and Microsoft, they have like a better production line, say, than compared to Nintendo, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
Or at least they have to see if they like get their production lines in order.
I just think Nintendo's... Go ahead.
Production line.
Go ahead.
It's not about production line. They do that shit on purpose.
Yeah, I think they're mad conservative with what they put out there, man.
Like with the NES Classic, they did that on purpose so they know that the SNES one is going to sell.
It's free advertising for them.
Yep. Nintendo is...
That's a smart business move.
Unfortunately, it's also...
And they're a business,
It's also
what the
a scalp.
Fuck? I can't kill
it's
you.
Also, it's also a scalper's wet dream.
It sure is.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I was gonna say, they did do that with the Wii when it came out too.
But eventually, Wii's became eventually able to be found. I know.
Yeah.
Well, because they were all lying in some kind of like, you know, buried ground or something, like no games to play on it.
Well, this is. I mean, I'm talking about like within a couple of weeks, but this system has been the fastest selling system Nintendo's ever had, apparently.
Yeah.
It's like selling so, Jesus Christ, selling so fucking fast.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. Amara says, I just hope you didn't have your hopes pinned on the NES Classic because Nintendo said hashtag nope. Yeah,
nope.
Man. It's not in their best interest to keep Switches out of people's hands because they're going to need to get that install base to compete with the other major systems that are out there. So they're gonna have to step up production or, you know, get more out there. And I think by the summer there'll be plenty out there.
Well, Nintendo also doesn't really know how to multitask very well either.
I'm not going to argue that. I won't argue that at all. Oh my god.
And plus, even though the NES Classic is still pretty recent, it's still taking an older console, so they're gonna abandon that real quick. That's the Nintendo's bottle, too.
Oh, come on.
Yeah.
Well, once the NES Classic comes to fate,
Let's see. Well, I doubt it's gonna be anytime this year, because the Switch is still gonna be selling a hotcakes.
Yeah.
I am curious, though, if this is, if them doing these classic things is it's going to give them, give them excuse to not really care much about the Virtual Console on the Switch.
I think it's the opposite. I think, like, the first games you're going to see on the Virtual Console are going to be the ones for the NES Classic.
Well, they're mostly on there anyways, aren't they? For, like, the Wii and Wii U?
Yeah,
but
not for the Switch.
Sure, I think most
yeah.
of them
are,
but not all of them, though.
Well, it's only about converting to bring them over on there. It's not that, should be that hard to do.
And
but it's Nintendo.
Wii U or the Wii.
Yeah, but saying they still have some kind of architecture there, they just have to convert it to bring on the Switch.
These guys want to get up here hard, son!
I mean, plus, those games, they really need resources to play. If a computer from like 2 decades ago can play that on a ROM, they can play
this guy with the
game on a Switch without a problem.
Yes, but this is Nintendo we're talking about.
I know. But I'm just saying, I mean, because what's the excuse for the 3DS? There's not enough horsepower. If the Wii U and the Wii can handle it, then the Switch can.
Even with, like, the Wii and the Wii U, they've been infamously slow in, like, updating their store.
Well, that actually applies to be competent online in the first place.
Yeah, but it's kind of like, it's like, oh, well, I gotta wait, like, a year for this system to get all the Virtual Console stuff the previous system got, if that.
Well, like I said, it's like 2 steps forward,
fuck!
and like 1.5
don't
steps back.
Ah, man, fucking almost had you, though. So good. Don't worry, I'm coming for you.
Yeah, man,
I'm coming for that ass.
I'm Soul Bro, get his ass.
But you know what? Even if it doesn't come on there, there's always ROMs.
There's always gonna be ROMs.
Thank you, fellas! Thank you, man. Let me go wipe this guy out.
People played with ROM for over 10 years now, so they're not going anywhere.
I prefer to support the company if possible, but yeah, I agree.
The
question is, it will properly emulate FX chip stuff if they're going to spend time doing that.
Might be a bit tricky.
But that's the thing, it'd be worth it to get it if, like, properly emulate Star Fox.
And plus, you know the certain games are not going to put on Virtual Console. You think you can get Turtles in Time or anything, right? So those Disney games again?
Yeah, it's going to cost a lot more money to get those.
Yeah, third parties.
Mm-hmm. And you know, some of those Capcom games and everything.
Woo!
Yeah, there's kind of a reason behind actually why those, like the old Star Fox and some of those ones haven't come out. It's because of the stuff behind the company who helped develop the Super FX chip and all that stuff for Nintendo anyway. There's like some behind the scenes stuff I've heard that is kind of part of the reason why that they haven't put them out.
Well, but the thing is, they can make it
because
also...
Because the thing that happened with Star Fox 2 is like they cancel it and then eventually like left other stuff from that and then it was like some weird stuff with the developer and all this kind of thing. That's like, that's why they haven't come out, because it's like, oh yeah, those games, we won't put them out because we still have a little bit of something in them that we technically hold on to. Even though they're, you know, Nintendo properties, you know, the characters, like Star Fox Universe.
But, you know, sometimes Nintendo can, you know, solve some of these things through. Remember how long it took for, what's it called, Super Mario RPG to come out on Virtual Console?
Yeah.
I want to look into that, but it's like, because I watched this, the videos, like, on, does anyone know Larry Bundy Jr.?
British guy? Yeah.
He had on that in like one of his segments once, like Facton he calls it, so.
Well, you never know, but just, you know, stay cautious and optimistic.
Oh, Jesus.
Sweet Jesus.
And like we said, people will always resort to let more means.
Nice try.
Oh, I'm still waiting for a match.
I'm about to, like, end
this. Let's go! Oh my sweet lord.
Alright,
yeah, looks like Doc is just happy with his Wii trainer.
Wii Fit Trainer, man. Got her, the amiibo?
Or it could be Natalie, though, saying it too.
So. Alright, shoot that.
One of his personalities?
One of his personas?
One of his personas.
No, no, no. I think Doc is Baron Ashura from Mazinger. You know, he's half man. He's like, you know, Doc on one side and Natalie.
Oh, fuck!
Yeah.
Oh my god! Fuck your bombs, alright? Fuck them.
I'm about to enter a deep hole that I don't think I'm going to be able to get out of.
Oh my god. My nose is so itchy. Fuck that!
Oh yeah, it's allergy season.
I know, man. It's like, I've got like a fire going on inside my nose. It's not fucking cool.
What?
Feels it's like itchy, man. It's like I got asbestos in my nose for some fucking reason.
Have you seen how dusty your room is?
Yeah, it's pretty dusty, but I dusted it all. I actually dusted it a couple days ago. Fuck, including my computer. I got air. I got a can of air, but it's probably scattered around, so that's probably what's fucking me up. Oi, let's go. We can push back, y'all. Come on.
If these guys are actually smart, they will actually hang around the base and keep me from getting out of it. See, I can't get out the base. There's someone always here.
Ah! Shit!
There might be more pink than aqua, though.
Nah, it's more aqua than pink, man. Look at all the big metal. If pink wins this, look, I'll be bottom, shocked.
Yeah.
Let's see here. Oh, wow! I'm mind fucked.
Well.
I'm mind fucked. All right, good shit. Let me fix my face.
You guys kept me out the game, man.
Yo, Barton.
You guys kept me out the fucking game.
Yo, shout out to Johnson. Number one stunner.
I'll be back.
No problem.
Skip out on again.
This next match is my last before I take a break to switch over to Mario Kart. That's what I'm about to do. Yo,
So, bro, have you tried any saline nasal sprays?
I haven't tried any. I should get on that though, man, because I've taken a nasal spray a long time ago, but
I'm saying not the, like, the allergy one. I'm talking about the actual saline ones. Because
mm-hmm.
You know, it's just salt mixed with, you know, like hot water. It like flushes out the nose completely. Because, you know, unlike regular nasal sprays, your nose gets congested and, you know, contracts itself. So saline, you know, like pushes out and clears your nose.
Not a bad. Thank you for heads up on that. I'll try it out and see what's up.
Yeah, they actually work. There's two ways you can do it. You can do it at home and everything. You know, just, you know, put some salt, some hot water, and mix it.
That's true. I have a neti potty which I could do that with too, which is not too bad. It comes with saline for me to do that with. I only used it once, but it was really good when I used it. It's just the draining of the nose is like the big thing that messes me up. They have a machine now you can do that shit where it's a bit more convenient.
It's not. Okay.
Yeah, it works. But for me, I don't like shit going up my nose. I see liquid.
Yeah, that's what I have a big difficult thing with, because I feel I'm going to drown standing up on land.
But what are you talking about? I have no problem doing that with my cocaine.
Hey, James, man! Hey, Chance, what's going on, Chance? Fuck! Fuck a duck!
Hey, man, when I'm with my rocks and everything,
that might have worked for somebody else, Silver. I'm
you
sorry.
Dudes!
God damn it!
So, Silver, have you been watching any, shows besides, like, Quiet Scout stuff?
He doesn't even watch that.
Well, which one?
Yeah. Oh, Quiet really is kept, actually.
Yeah.
It's been super quiet. Oh my god. I've not caught up on Arrow Flash since they came back from the break. I am caught up on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I will say that. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I just binged one particular day when I had some free time.
It's been so good lately.
Yeah, and then I have not caught up on the Hydra season. But before they went to break, I was caught up. So
I know I've been watching it on your Hulu.
Oh!
So it's not gonna say new when you set up.
You sack!
Ghost Rider's still in it.
Ghost Rider. I'm hoping he'll show up towards the end of the season.
Okay, because I know he disappeared with that mid-season break, so.
Yeah, he's been gone for a while, yeah.
It's kind of related, but you
dude,
know
that... Ghost Rider is like the first story arc. They're already on the third.
Yeah. Okay. I'm sure there'll be a fourth one before the season's up, but...
Because I thought he was part of the title screen.
God damn it.
That's what I was wondering.
Because he's such a popular character, I can't see them finishing out the season without finding a way to bring him back. Once they get out of the Hydra world, that is.
Yeah, one thing I'm kind of worried about, you know that upcoming Inhuman show?
Yeah.
The moron that was a showrunner for Iron Fist.
He's the showrunner for this. Yeah, that does have me worried.
Moron.
Yeah, fucking Scott Buck is his name. Yeah, Iron Fist. I finished it. That's one show I could say I watched all the way through.
I'll struggle through it before Defenders come out.
I just go to Wikipedia.
Damn, someone finally stopped my fucking serial killer.
And then there's...
I was on a streak.
And then there's the trailer for Cloak and Daggers that came out.
Oh, okay.
Did it come out?
Huh. Yeah, the trailer came out, I think, 2 days ago. I'm a mixed bag on it. I'm going to check it out. I'm going to give it its fair shot because it is Marvel, and I'll definitely give it a shot. But it looks...
He killed it.
Fucking terrible.
Awesome, bro. It's
you gotta carry your team on that one, bro.
I was on my back, bro. Oh, my God. Good games, though. Good games, guys. It's fucking great. Yo, shout out to Laura. You said you take that title back. Yo, Laura, what's up? It's good to see you.
Wow, and I still got points. Ain't that some shit?
Title back is what I named my stream. Good riddance to Mario Kart 8.
Good riddance!
Hey.
You'll be playing that next week.
Be gone. Yeah.
You should suffer with us at least one more time.
That's the same
player. Hey, yeah, same game, different code of paint.
It has a whole other fucking mode added to it.
You know,
we'll probably play it once and go back.
A whole
you
a whole
will play it
form
once.
Of, a whole other form of bullshit.
What was the name? What was the saying we gave it? The saying of 2015. Difficult but fair.
A tough but fair.
Tough
but fair.
It's the my tombstone.
You know what, Joe? I don't think you ever lived out that pun I made about tunnel vision that one time.
I don't remember it.
Damn.
That was a good time.
Jesus.
Oh, I was on a roll that night.
Terrible.
Yeah, show compared me to Zack Snyder.
What?
Shit. Yeah, he said I should be stopped like Zack Snyder from being a DC.
That's some shit.
He'll stop him. He must be stopped. Oh, God. All right, I'm going to drop off real quick so I can take a quick break, go get myself some water. When we get back, it'll be Mario Kart 8 on the Wii U. If you got the game, the race code is going to be on... I'll put it in the chat for anybody who wants to jump into the race. If we don't have enough races for the code, we'll just drive publicly, man. Fuck it. But that's what's up. Here's the race code for Mario Kart 8 on the Wii U. Hope to see you guys there. I'll be right back, fellas. All right, guys. Hang tight. When we get back, more... Nintendo Friday, man, here on Shin Station's Level 9. Be back in a few minutes.
Burning lust for revenge pushed him to and beyond the limit where normal men would fall.